This is Dabu 7. We know that the powers that be never let a crisis go to waste. And it seems that there's one churned up right now, and it may just catch many people off guard. We've had insiders warning and warning about the inflation and the printing of money for years now, but we're on the cusp of a CBDC being rolled out and the power being given to the government to track any and every move everyone makes worldwide with the U.S. dollar. Now, banks are closing up at a record pace. We had 54 just close up in this past week. AI and robots moving in all over the place. And the warning signs are definitely there. The financial crisis, so to speak, is going to be rolled out so that they can send emergency funds to the people that need it via these digital wallets. Now, there's about to be a huge event that most people don't even see coming. Yahoo Finance has already let the cat out of the bag in other places on speaking about the recall that is about to take place. That's right, a recall. And because most people are turning the cheek the other way or sticking their head in the sand, they're going to get blindsided by this. And I compare it to the Nixon shock. I'm going to go ahead and call it the Biden shock. When they come out and they announce the recall of the U.S. dollar. This has never happened in your lifetime, nor will it ever again. This is going to be one of those once-in-a-lifetime moves that you better be prepared for. They're going to call this back. They're going to say that you can turn it in for a CBDC in exchange. And this is going to start a frenzy. And you're going to see right then if people in mass are going to accept this in the United States or if they're going to reject it like they did in Nigeria and other places. Because people woke up to see that this is all about tracking when it comes to the blockchain and its technology. We also had the feds come out this week and admit there's major privacy concerns when it comes to the CBDC. And they said it right out in the open, but it seemed like no one was listening. So everything is in motion and the stage is set that by November 1st, 2 p.m. in the afternoon, the Biden regime could come out and make an announcement from that point on, at any time from that point on, about a recall on the U.S. dollar. I'm telling you right now, most people are about to get absolutely blindsided by this. Join me on the live streams where I talk about this in greater detail, what you can do to mitigate the damage, and what we can do to survive everything that's coming our way, period. Going live Monday and Friday on DLive and on Rumble. Have a special panel on Mondays with Tuj and Crazy Tacos. Make sure to check us out over here. You'll find links below. Much love.
All right, Shalom. Shalom, Shalom. Before I start, I want to give all honors and glories and praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Mahabah, Kakodash, Yahweh, which is the one true name of the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Shai, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ, but his one and true name is Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone, who will well and teach well, because those are the men who I learned this truth from through the spirit and power of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. Peace, blessings, salutations to the hopeful elect. And shalom to you, sincere brothers scattered abroad, pushing forth this word in truth and sincerity. I am the brother Mashiach Razakah from the servants of Yahweh Yahweh Shai Camp, Las Vegas, Nevada branch. And pretty much in this lesson, it's going to be titled as the dollar is getting ready to collapse. The dollar is getting ready to collapse. And pretty much the fiat currency, the value of the dollar is continuing to decrease. There's no value in the dollar anymore, a fiat currency. So now they're pushing the CBDC into that new currency as what has been spoken of by the men of the Lord for many, many years. And we're at the front door of this agenda. We're right at the front door. And I want to read this right here because he put something in the description which is very interesting. Let's read it. It says, I know that there is a lot going on in the world right now, but I just had to write about what is happening to our banks. And there's a lot of banks that's closing. Out here in Vegas, there's like four or five different Chase branch banks that closed in the past year. Banks just start closing. And it's kind of getting you scratching your head for a minute, like, what the hell? There's Banks closing. Yeah, there's banks closing. We know what is going into, what is leading into. They've taken out all the ATM machines. All these banks are just closing left and right. People are losing money out of their bank accounts. People are getting taken from their bank account $1,200. You know, the bank is not telling them where their money's being transferred to, what is going on. It's causing a lot of stress and anguish for many people. It says high interest rates and chaos in the real estate industry are combining to put an enormous amount of pressure on our largest financial institutions. As a result, banks are getting very tight with their money, and we see that going on. It says they are closely down hundreds of branches, and they are laying off thousands of workers, like Amazon. They have been laying off people way more frequently. They've been letting go hundreds of people. 200 people getting let go. 500 people getting let go. They're letting people go. People are becoming unemployed. And it's starting to bug people out because people got bills. They got kids. People got, you know, rent they got to pay, etc. They stressed out. It says, we are in the early stages of the worst financial crisis since 2008 and 2009. And it says, and I fully expect conditions to get even worse in months ahead. So this is what is due to come. Now, this was uploaded about a month ago. But at the end of the day, it's still, this information still needs to get out there. There's a lot of things that are transpiring across the world. And just because it may not happen in your city, it still is a part of the U.S. And you have to, you know, this is why we have to pray to the Lord and ask the Lord for mercy and to keep us embedded in the faith. Because we're headed into some devastating times. We're headed into some hard times. Things are going to start getting out of hand pretty soon. It's going to lead to a lot of civil and unrest. Because they're pushing forth the CBDC, and they're going to make that the new currency. And you're not going to be able to survive or make it in this country without that CBDC. And if you take that CBDC, or should I say the MOTB, which will lead to that CBDC, which will be that MOTB. If you take that MOTB, Salakia, you will be destroyed. Because there's no repentance for taking the MOTB. The MOTB, it will lead to that being the new currency. Because they're putting forth a central digital currency. And let's get to Jeremiah 30, Salakia. Jeremiah 30 in verse 5, it says, for thus saith the Lord. Anytime you see Lord in caps, it's talking about the Heavenly Father Yahweh. We have heard a voice of trembling, of fear, and not of peace. We're not in a time of peace. There's banks closing. There's people getting laid off of jobs. There's a lot of things going on in the world. You got things that's taking place out in Hamas, Gaza, right? Palestine. There's a lot of things going on across the world. You got Russia creating all these new world war weapons, etc. You got America going through the financial situation. They're gonna have another shutdown, but now they're not. But they were trying to have, they're getting ready to have another shutdown coming, you know, and they don't want to have another shutdown because that's going to bug a lot of people out. You know, people ain't going to be able to work. They ain't going to have any way to make it, you know, and this is why, again, we need to be seeking the Lord. It says, for thus saith the Lord, we have heard a voice of trembling, of fear, not of peace. We're not in a time of peace. Look at the things that's going on the earth. Things is just getting worse and worse and worse and worse. You know, verse 6, it says, as ye know and see whether a man doeth travail with child, a man doesn't travail with child, a woman does. It says, wherefore do I see every man with his hands on his loins as a woman in travail, and all faces are turned into paleness, feeble and weak. Because you're going to have a lot of people, they're going to bug out. When they bring forth that CBDC and you got to go in there and use your credit card and they're not taking your credit card, or you try to use your debit card, they're not taking your debit card or credit card. And then you see the next person in line across from you go and scan their hand. That's going to trip your mind out. Like, what the hell? That's going to be the new system. You try to use your money. We ain't taking fiat currency anymore. What are you going to do? That's going to have your mind blown. That's going to bug you. That's going to bug an individual out. You're going to be bugged out, feeble and weak. It says, verse 7, Alas, for that day is great, so there is none like it. It says, it is even a time of Jacob trouble. Yes, we are all going to have to go through Jacob trouble first before we can be saved. No, we're not already in Jacob trouble. And no, we're not going to be saved before Jacob trouble. And no, Jacob trouble is not just going to be on the heathens. It's going to be on the Israelites. That's why it's called Jacob's trouble. We have to go through Jacob trouble first before we can be saved. It says, but he shall be saved out of it. That's the elect. They're going to be saved, but they got to go through Jacob trouble first before they can be saved. Let's prove that. This is Daniel. Salakia. Daniel 12:1. This is Daniel 12:1. It says, and at that time shall Michael stand up, Michael the archangel, right? The great prince which standeth for the children of thy people, right? And there shall be a time of trouble, Jacob trouble, such as never was since there was a nation even to the same time. And at that time, thy people shall be delivered, every one that shall be found written in the book. And this is talking about Jacob's trouble. We have to go through Jacob's trouble first before we can be saved. So if you're a person that believe we're going to be saved before Jacob's trouble, you're wrong. If you're a person to believe that we're already in Jacob's trouble right now, in this present moment, right now as I'm speaking, you believe we're already in Jacob's trouble, this is Jacob's trouble, you're wrong. If you're a person that believe that Jacob's trouble is only going to be on the heathen nations and not the Israelites, you're wrong. All those scenarios of your beliefs, if you believe in those scenarios, you are wrong. We are not in Jacob's trouble. For one, number two, we're not going to be saved before Jacob trouble. And number three, Jacob trouble is not going to just be on the heathens. It's going to be on the Israelites. But we got to go through Jacob trouble first before we can be saved. That's called the hour of temptation. So for those of you out there that believe in that type of philosophies and false doctrines, because those are false doctrines, you're going to be in a bad situation because none of those scenarios is correct. We have to go through Jacob trouble first before we can be saved. That's why the scriptures tells us this. The scriptures warns us and tells us what we are to do right now in this moment. Micah 2:10. Arise ye, you, ye means you, and depart. Depart from what? Depart from the philosophies of this society, the ways of this society. Being embedded in its politics, its philosophies, and false religions. Drunken of that wine. Come out of that. Depart from that. Right? It says, for this is not your rest. This is not your rest. This place called America, which is Babylon the Great. If you are a so-called Negro, Hispanic, Native American Indian, this place is not your rest. There's things around you that is taking place that you're not realizing. That you're not obtaining to or looking at. That you're not paying attention to. There's a lot of things that are taking place on the earth. And you cannot be stupid. It says, because it is polluted. What is polluted? The philosophies, the religions, the politics, right? The being brought up here in the ways of Esau, Edom, and his kingdom and his rulership, of his education systems, and etc. It's all polluted. It says, it shall destroy you. It shall destroy you even with a sore destruction. Even with a sore destruction. So you're going to receive a judgment if you stay embedded in this place called America. That's why the scriptures tells us, and I believe it's Jeremiah 50, I believe, maybe, or 51, right, where it tells us right here, verse 6, Jeremiah 51:6, the scriptures gives you warning. Flee out of the midst of Babylon, right? That's talking about spiritually, Micah 2:10, right? Flee out of the midst of Babylon and deliver every man his soul. That's talking about spiritually. You are to flee out of the midst of Babylon. Spiritually. Get out of, come out of the ways of this society. Be not cut off in her iniquity. See, you don't want to be in her iniquity. Because the different heathen nations are drunken of the wine. They right now, they're laying in bed with the whore right now. Which is America. Which goes to, again, Revelations, the 18th chapter and the 17th chapter. It talks about that. Right? They have lied down with the whore. That whore is America. That's that whore. Right? You want to come out of her iniquities. You don't want to be caught in her plague. It says, for this is the time of the Lord's vengeance. You don't want to be caught up in that. It says, he will render unto her, talking about America, she's that whore, a recompense. Recompense, repay, it's due, right? The Lord is going to do, the Lord is going to cast his vengeance on this place called America, and you don't want to be caught up in that. You do not want to be in that. You don't want to be caught up in that, because the Lord is going to destroy this place called America. Jacob trouble is coming, regardless if you believe it or not. So you don't want to be caught up in that. You don't want to be caught up in that. And I'm thinking about another precept now, because the scriptures gave us warning, right? Proverbs 1 and 22. It says, how long, ye simple ones, will ye love simplicity, and the scorners delight in their scorning, and fools hate knowledge? Meaning our people, two-thirds of our people, they're not taking heed to the truth. They're not taking heed to this gospel, this ministry, these scriptures. The warnings that the Lord is giving out through the Spirit in these holy scriptures. They're not taking heed to it. Verse 23, it says, turn you at my reproof, meaning correction. Behold, I will pour out my Spirit unto you, and I will make known my words unto you. That's what the Lord is telling you. Look, if you take heed to what I'm telling you through my prophets, and you take heed to that, I will make known my words unto you. You will receive the understanding. You will understand the principles of the gospel, the true understanding of this, right? Verse 24, because I have called and ye refuse, you refuse. You rejected this truth. You rejected this knowledge. You don't care about what the Bible says. You don't care what the Lord say. You want to continually do as thou wilt, right? I have stretched out my hand and no man regarded. Verse 25, but ye have set a knot. Ye have said a knot on my counsel and would none of my reproof. You didn't want correction. You wanted to do things the way you wanted to do them. Verse 26, I also will laugh at your calamity. So the Lord's going to laugh at your calamity. When things come down on you, you mock the prophets. So the Lord is going to mock you, and he's going to do it through his prophets. He's going to laugh at you through his prophets. Because a calamity is a disaster, a horrifying disaster event that's going to take place. That's what calamities mean. It says, I also will laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your fear cometh. You mock the prophets. So now when your fear cometh, the Lord's going to laugh and mock at you. And he's going to do that through his prophets. Verse 27, when your fear cometh as desolation and your destruction cometh as a whirlwind. Because it's going to come. It says, when distress and anguish shall come upon you. You're going to be distressed out. You're not going to be able to use your bank account. You're not going to be able to use your credit card, debit card. You know, it ain't going to matter about how much good credit you got. My credit's 700. My credit, 800. It ain't going to matter about none of that unless you be taking that MLTB, because that's going to be the new currency. And if you take that MLTB, you're going to be destroyed. Yes, you are going to be destroyed. There's no repentance for taking the MLTB, because that is going to lead to that. The CBDC, the central digital currency. That's what's going to cause a lot of distress and anguish. You're going to be bugged out. You're not going to be able to eat. You're not going to be able to work without taking that MLTB. Because that's what they're pushing for. That's their agenda. That's their goal. Verse 28. Then shall they call upon me. Then you're going to be trying to seek the Lord. When all these things take place of not being able to eat or work or survive, you know, and no food to eat, etc., that's when people are going to want to seek the Lord. But it's going to be too late. But I will not answer. They shall seek me early, but they shall not find me. Verse 29. For that they hated knowledge, you hated knowledge at the time. Those men out there were teaching, you didn't take heed to it. You either was ignoring it, you was calling those guys crazy, or those dudes is crazy on the corner over there. They just yelling at people, this, and that. Not paying attention to what they're saying. You just looking at them. They yelling. They telling people this. They telling people that. Them guys are a cult. These guys are Pharisees and all this bugged out shit. You didn't want to take heed to it. It says, verse 29, it says, for that they hated knowledge. You didn't take heed to it. You were against it. And did not choose to fear the Lord. You didn't choose to fear the Lord, not realizing the Lord is speaking through those men, and you rejected the Lord. You didn't want to take heed to what the Lord was giving through the Spirit. You wanted to mock and scoff and be a demon and speak against those men. So now this is going to come for you. Verse 30. They would none of my reproof. It says, they would none of my counsel, they despise all my reproof, correction. See? So now the time is going to come where you're going to be left out there and you're going to be a messed up individual. Yeah, the time is going to come where you're going to be a messed up individual. So this is why you want to fear the Lord and you want to seek the Lord to the best of your ability. Because there's going to be a lot of things to take place on the earth, regardless if you believe in this or not. Babylon the Great is falling and it is coming down to its downfall. And you don't want to be in that. 2 Esdras 15 and 1. Behold, I speak unto that. It says, behold, speak thou in the ears of my people the words of prophecy. And that's what the men of the Lord are doing. The scriptures also mention that in Ezekiel 35, right? Speak against Mount Seir, which is America. It says, 2 Esdras 15 and 1. Behold, speak thou in the ears of my people the words of prophecy which I will put in thy mouth, saith the Lord. So the Lord always set up prophets. He always set up men. Going all the way back to Numbers 11 and verse 16 through 17 and reading down from verse 24 to 31. The Lord always set up men to follow. The Lord always spoke through men. The Lord always put his spirit on his men, on his prophets, on what to say and what to teach. Because it's not us that's speaking. It's the Lord Yahweh Bashimashai speaking through us, putting the spirit on us to give out this truth. Alright? And what to say. Verse 2, it says, and cause them to be written in paper, for they are faithful and truth. Everything in the scriptures is true, regardless if you believe it or not. Verse 3, it says, fear not the imaginations against thee. Right. People speak against us. People come against us. Yeah, a lot of people come. Our own people come against us. It says, let not the incredulity of them trouble thee that speak against thee. Right, because the scriptures mention that in Ezekiel, I think it's Ezekiel 30, right? Ezekiel 30, and I believe it's 30 and 31 through 32, where they speak against us. You know, they be in their houses talking all types of mess. The scriptures mention that, of them talking against the men of the Lord, talking against us, right? So don't let the incredulity of them trouble thee that speak against thee. Because the Lord is going to deal with them. Those that don't acknowledge the Messiah, they're unbelievers. Those that are against this gospel, they're unbelievers. They're antichrist. They're unbelievers. This is why the scriptures say for them, this is what's coming for them. Those that have been giving the men of the Lord trouble, like that individual that was giving us trouble at camp yesterday, this is going to be his judgment. Because he want to believe in Esau and he's under the Stockholm Syndrome. He want to believe in Esau and joining hands with Esau and he has it all, and they're rich, they're this, they're that. Well, guess what? This is what's going to be your demise. Verse 4, for all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness. He's going to die in his unfaithfulness. That individual that came up against us at camp, he's going to die in his unfaithfulness, because he's an unbeliever. He don't believe in the Messiah either. He believe in Yahweh. You got a Yahweh demon on him. Verse 5, it says, behold, saith the Lord, I will bring plagues upon the world. See, the Lord is going to bring plagues upon the world. It says the sword, famine, death, and destruction. See, the sword, famine, death, and destruction. This is the plague that the Lord is bringing upon this place called America, which is coming. Verse 6, for wickedness have exceedingly polluted the whole earth, and their hurtful works are fulfilled. Con, it has. Their hurtful works are fulfilled. They're pushing forth unrighteous decrees, as the scriptures mention Isaiah 10 and 1, right? Woe unto them that push forth unrighteous decrees, right? And I'm going to get that out. I want to get that out too, Bob Kishaw. Isaiah, I think it's 10 and 1. Unrighteous decrees. Yep. It's right here. It says, woe unto them that decree unrighteous decrees. And that's Esau, Edom. He's pushing forth all these agendas. He's pushing all these agendas to bring out. He's going to come in like a flood, as the scriptures say. And that right grievousness which they have prescribed. They push forth unrighteous decrees. That's Esau, Edom. The scriptures. That's why the scriptures tells us not to trust our enemies. The scriptures tells us that. Never trust thine enemy. So does the IRS. So does his wickedness. So you don't want to trust. You don't want to trust in your enemy. We have enemies. These 17 heathen nations are our enemies. Let's skip down to verse 9. Behold, my people is led as a flock to slaughter. I will not suffer them now to dwell in the land of Egypt, right? Which is talking about this place called America. Verse 11, but I will bring them with a mighty hand and a stretched out arm, and will smite Egypt with plagues as before. Now, this ain't talking about ancient Egypt. This is talking about America, which is Babylon the Great. The Lord did put plagues on ancient Egypt. That's why he says he's going to put plagues on it as before. But where it says smite Egypt, that's talking about this place called America, with plagues as before, and will destroy all the land thereof. Verse 12, Egypt shall mourn, which is America, and the foundation of it shall be smitten with the plague and the punishment that the Lord, that our Lord power Yahweh shall bring upon it. Because the Lord is going to cast his judgment on the earth. Ezekiel 34:8 talks about that. Let's get that. I read that. Let's get that. I think it's is it Ezekiel? I said Ezekiel. Isaiah. I'm sorry, Salakia. Isaiah 34 in verse 8. The Lord said he's gonna do his vengeance. Verse 34 and 8. For it is the day of the Lord's vengeance. See, the Lord is gonna take vengeance on this place called America, not us. And the year of, it says, and the year of recompense for the controversy of Zion. Because the Lord is going to do his vengeance for what this place called America did to his people. That's why all of these things is taking place on the earth. You see all these plagues that the Lord is pushing upon it. But it's going to be intensified in the time of Jacob trouble. It's going to be way worse in the time of Jacob trouble. All right, let's skip down to verse 14. Woe to the world and them that dwell therein. For that word woe means warning and destruction too, by the way. Verse 15. For the sword and their destruction draw off nigh, and one people shall stand up to fight against another with swords in their hands. Right? And this is a future prophecy which is getting ready to come. Because it's going to be a lot of rebellion. It's going to be sedition, which means to revolt of authority, come against. Right, that's going to lead into the martial law. People are going to take matters into their own hands. Everybody's not going to get that MLTB. Verse 16, it says, for there shall be sedition. And that word sedition means revolt of authority, rebel against, revolt against. They're not going to comply to that system. It says, for there shall be sedition among men invading one another. They shall not regard their kings nor princes in the course of their actions shall stand in their power. See, so Esau Edom ain't going to be able to control these people here. They're going to lose control of this society. So that's when they're going to bring forth that martial law, which is going into verse 17. It says, a man shall desire to go into the city and shall not be able. That's leading into martial law. You're not going to be able to go into the city. You're not going to be able to go into the city at that time, because it's going to be a lot of mayhem, uproars. People are going to revolt against the elites, the high powers in this society, the high power elites. People are going to revolt against that. Everybody's not going to comply to that MLTB. And when that is established as a new currency and it's pushed and it's mandated, everybody's not going to comply to that. That's going to lead a lot of uproars and civil unrest. Verse 18, for because of their pride, the city shall be troubled. See, it says, and the houses shall be destroyed and men shall be afraid, because it's going to see a lot of things take place. It's going to be so much mayhem going on. It's not even going to be funny. You're going to be thinking you're in a Grand Theft Auto video game, but it's going to be worse than that. Verse 19, a man shall have no pity upon his neighbor, because in that time, everybody's going to have the concept of every man for themselves. They're not going to care and worry about what the next person is going through. Hey, I got to worry about me, my family, and my kids. That's how it's going to be. It's going to be every man for themselves. That's a mindset. And you're even going to have people that you are close friends with that's going to betray you and take everything that you got just to survive for him and his family. So it's going to be a lot of betrayal. It's going to be a lot of every man for themselves. It's going to be a lot of these type of politics that's going to be going on amongst the earth. Salakia. It says, a man shall have no pity upon his neighbor, but shall destroy their houses with a sword and spoil their goods because of the lack of bread and for great tribulation. See, so that's what's going to take place. That's what's going to cause a lot of mayhem for a lot of people, because the things that are going to be taking place on the earth is going to be devastating a lot of people. Verse 70, and this is also going into Jacob trouble. It says, for there shall be in every place in the next cities a great insurrection upon those that fear the Lord. Verse 71, they shall be like mad men, sparing none, but still spoiling and destroying those that fear the Lord. Verse 72, for they shall waste and take away their goods and cast them out of their houses. And this is going into Jacob trouble, every man for themselves. This is going into the hour of temptation, Jacob trouble, etc. Right? Verse 73, then shall they be known who are the who are my chosen, and they shall be tried as the gold in the fire, because it's going to be the hour of temptation. You're going to be tried on your faith. And this is why we say you law crazy Israelites in the Jacob trouble, you ain't going to be able to keep the laws, ain't going to save you. Faith is what's going to save you, because you're going to be tried on a high level in that time. You're going to be, this is why you got to be fully persuaded in your mind, and you got to consistently pray and ask the Lord to keep you with the spiritual gift of faith. Faith is what's going to save you. Keeping laws in the time of Jacob trouble, that's not going to save you. Faith is what's going to save you. That's why the scriptures say in verse 73, then shall they be known who are my chosen, and they shall be tried. They're going to be tried on what? Their faith, right? As the gold in the fire. See, verse 74, hear, O ye my beloved, saith the Lord, behold, the days of trouble are at hand. It's talking about Jacob's trouble, but I will deliver you from the same. See, the Lord is going to be there with us. Verse 75, be ye not afraid nor doubt, for the Most High is your guide. See, because all we're going to have in that time is the Lord Yahweh Bashimashai. So, hey, perilous times, and I want to get that scripture too. Perilous times. I was thinking about that. Let me see if I can get that. Perilous times. If not, I can. Here it is. Second. This is second. Is it 2 Timothy? Yep. 2 Timothy 3 and 1. It says, this know also that in the last days, perilous times shall come. And that's the time we're coming into. Perilous times shall come. So it's not looking good here in this place called America. It's not looking good. It's not looking good here in this place called America, man. Things are starting to crumble. Things are starting to fall, break apart. So, hey, Lord willing, this lesson is edifying. Till next time, I say, Shalom.